Hey guys, I'm here, Brian with Fort Knox Company, and I wanted to show you how easy it is to replace a plug on maybe your extension cord. This is just one of those aftermarket parts you can buy. Here we're going to be replacing the female side, but you can do this for the male or female. But what happened was I had this extension cord for a long time, and I got it caught in something and I ripped through it. So I'm going to just snip off about a foot or so. And I'm gonna install a new plug and then we can use this cord again safely. I'll show you guys how easy it is and how fast it is. This is just a couple dollar part. I'll put a link in the video for you guys and you can have it to your house in just a couple days from Amazon. It's faster than going to the store nowadays. But I'll show you guys how easy it is. This is just one type, but I'll put a good one there in the link in the description below. Step one, cut the cord. So I'm gonna snip the cord just, just below where it was cut, where I had worn through it. I'm doing this one-handed, but you just snip it. So now that I've cut the cord, I get to focus a little bit. You can see that I got a green, a white, and a black. So my black and white will be my neutral and my hot, and then the green will be my ground. And then inside this plug, I'll show you how we connect those. We'll also have to strip back this housing or the casing a couple inches just to be able to work with these wires. So first we'll strip this back, expose some of the wire. I like using these Kling Tools wire strippers. Again, I'll put the link to these, but I stopped wasting my money on the cheap stuff and I went with Kling Tools. It's just a couple dollars more, but they're actually built to work the way that you want them to work. So no more frustration, you know, using the cheap tools. And this lasts and is built well, so I use these to kind of do all my electrical. So I've cut back the casing a little bit, just a couple inches. We will expose a little bit of wire here in just a second. But now that we're working with this aftermarket plug, there's usually a little set screw. You take that set screw off and then you can pull the face out. And then inside there, we'll be able to actually connect the wires. We'll feed the cord through, connect the wires, push the face back in and then set it with the screw. So I'll open this up here. So we've gotten the screw out, and then you can just push it out from the back. And you can see here, we're gonna install the positive, or the hot wire, and the ground, or the neutral. You'll see in the instructions that it usually comes with, it'll tell you that we usually do the white wire to the silver and the hot wire or black to the brass, but I would still confirm with whatever your instructions say. But that's commonly how we see these electricals, is that the white goes to the silver and that the black goes to the bronze or the gold. So that's how we'll connect these wires. And then the neutral goes here on this and we'll slip it back into this housing right there before we put it back into the shell of the plug. First, we gotta feed the wire through here, strip these down, and then start connecting them. So now I've connected the black to the bronze, the white to the silver, and the green and ground. And then we can just pull the sleeve right back over and put the set screw back in. And we'll have this thing ready to go. So that's how easy it is. Once you get the face in, you can put the set screw back and you're good to go. You can use this thing for however long, a couple more years, who knows. But if you ever damage a cord or something like that, you can always replace these plugs. It costs just a couple bucks and it's a lot cheaper than having to buy a whole new extension cord. So you get some more life out of it. This is a cheaper version that I found and it works just as good, but it is a little bit more difficult to hook up. You can see how I had to screw the wires on, and there's some better versions that I'll put a link in the description there, where you can actually like push the wires on. You don't have to screw them in. It's a little bit easier to actually put together, but the main thing is that there's nothing crazy going on. It's just three wires that you have to connect, and it's something you can definitely do yourself, nothing to be afraid of. So if you guys haven't already, hit like, let me know if you liked the video. If you have any questions, put them in the comments down below. and subscribe to my channel. You know, it really helps me out and I appreciate it. I do a lot of stuff like this, like quick fixes and other big DIY projects. So I really appreciate it if you subscribe, and I guess I'll see you on the next build.